The MLXFAN language to define models for monoliths includes some keywords that allow to access information from the dosing design in the structural model. I will show what these keywords are and how to use them with some examples. First, let me recall that the standard way of using dosing information in the structural model is with MLXFAN macros that automatically apply the dosing amounts from the dataset at the corresponding dosing times to some variable in the system. The different macros are PK model, absorption or oral, IV, and DPOT. For some of these macros, it is possible to specify different types of administration with the argument ADM and the target variable in the model. An example is shown here with two different types of doses that are applied to the model, one implemented as an absorption route with the macro absorption, and the other as intravenous route with IV. In addition to this, doses from the design can also be referenced in MLXFAN through several independent variables that can be accessed via reserved keywords. The keyword AMT dose that corresponds to the amount of the last administered dose read from the column amount of the dataset. The keyword T dose that defines the time of the last administered dose read from the column time of the dataset. And the keyword INFT dose that contains the infusion time of the last administered dose read from the column infusion time of the dataset. These keywords can be used directly for some calculations in the structural model without requiring to use a regressor. However, when using them, you should keep in mind a few characteristics. First, they do not discriminate doses that correspond to different administration types, even when the dataset contains a column administration ID. Moreover, they contain direct information from the dataset. Thus, even if you define some absorption characteristic in PK macros, such as a lag time or a proportional factor, they do not affect the values returned by this keyword. Finally, they contain the information from the last dose not only at the time of the dose, but until the next dose, so they define step functions that are null before the first dose. Here is a small example of three infusion doses given to an individual at times 10, 20, and 30, with different amounts and different infusion times. For this individual, the variables defined by the dose-related keywords are displayed with respect to time on these plots. We notice that at each dosing time, each keyword is updated with the values from the corresponding dose and stays then constant until the next dose. Let's now have a look at two small examples. The dose-related keywords can be useful for modeling custom absorptions for a single type of administration. For instance, the Weibull absorption model describes an absorption delay with a time-varying absorption rate that follows this formula, where the absorption rate Ka changes in a phenomenological way via a Weibull function. A model using this absorption is returned here as an ODE system with a DPOT compartment in which the amount of drug is the variable AD, and a central compartment with an amount AC. The transfer of drug from the DPOT compartment to the central compartment is described using the time-varying rate constant Ka time. To allow for multiple doses, the time has to be calculated with respect to the time of the last dose, using the T-dose keyword. On the right, you can see an example of simulation of this model in MLExplorer with three doses at time 10, 50, and 100, with decreasing amount. In this second example, AMT dose is simply used in the structural model to implement a dose-dependent bioavailability F that is then used in the macro PK model. Remember that for both examples, the values returned by the keywords depend on all doses received by each individual, whatever their administration type. That's it for today. See you next week for another video.